On March 9, 1991, the Community Covenant Church in Rehoboth, Massachusetts hosted the year's first performance by the Bullock Brothers Ministries. Strangers became friends, and friends became closer as they shared in a joyful interpretation of modern and traditional gospel music.
Group as the Bullock Brothers joined together in 1950, September 1950, and decided, hey, we're all in the city, we've been singing with different groups, let's get together and why not sing as the brothers? And that's how we got started. And it's been continuing ever since. The group actually started as six brothers. Right now there are two of us, Richard and I, are the original, two of the original members of the Bullock Brothers. And two of the brothers passed on, two of the brothers are still living, they just decided, well, you know, they didn't want to sing anymore. The difficulty has been making sure everyone focused on what we were singing about. We always be very friendly with the people. We're part of the people. And anytime we go someplace, they're there to greet us, and they're eager to see us, and wow, we're just hugging and handshakes, and we're happy to see you guys, and we're expecting you. And so it's always like that.
Song I love to sing because it talks about a home in glory, where we're all expecting to be there, to rejoice, live forevermore. It's called Over in the Glory Land.
I am on my way to my home over there, over in the Glory Land. With His praise I'll sing and His glory over in the glory land. I am on my way where the saints abide, over in the glory land, where I long to be by my Savior's side, over in the glory land.
I know it's just so over there. Ah, I'm gonna join. Woo! Over there,
over in the glory land.
Over there, yeah.
Over in the glory land.
They wanna sing and shout.
There's a precious fountain, well, free to all, a healing stream.
I ain't gonna tell nobody.
You know how it is sometimes, and I'm not going to tell you. I have a secret, but after a while, he said, I just couldn't hold it any longer. You know what I said? You want to help me down when it's shame. But I,
the words are, I said I wasn't going to tell nobody when God saved me. God did something great for me, and there was so much joy. You know, I said, oh, this is too great to tell someone. I'm not going to tell anyone. And so the words of the song go, but I couldn't keep it to myself. I just had to go and tell someone. And then the chorus of the song says, you should have been there. It tells about how great it was, and but I wasn't going to tell you, but it was so great, I just spilled it out. I had to tell you about it.
Tell me about Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
There was a story in the Bible about Elijah, the prophet, that was taken up in fiery chariot. And I thought about, I'm sure that when the writer wrote this song, he was thinking about, wouldn't it be wonderful to be taken up in that fiery chariot and be taken away and from all the problems that I have. So swing low, sweet chariot, and take me away.
You know, many years ago, back down in the cotton fields, people couldn't read and write like we can, and they couldn't read the Bible like we do, like we ought to do. Don't always do it, do you? But they heard about a story. You know about that story, Mother Richie? A man named Elijah, taken up by fire to the chariot. And I don't know, but I believe what they said was, come on there, chariot. Come on there, chariot. Come on there, chariot.
Whoa, whoa, Jordan. And what did I see? Coming, carry me home. I saw they were coming after me. They were coming for to carry said, swing low,
swing low,
sweet chariot. They were coming
to carry me home.
Swing low,
swing low,
sweet
chariot.
Oh, they were coming
for the carry me
home.
Chariot,
you're coming,
carry me
keep your mind on mine, Jesus' love. He's coming back real soon. And for the lost, there'll be no room. Watch and pray, this is what I say. Unless you fall down by the way, he's coming back real. For the lost, there'll be no room. Oh, yeah. Hold on to what you got. But you got a lot. Be ready when they come. Don't you get caught undone. Oh yeah. Jesus said he's
coming again,
but he never, never said when,
never said when.
Be ready when he comes, and don't you get caught. Take off the old man, put on the new.
Put on the new.
This is what Jesus is saying to you.
Saying to you.
He's coming back real soon. And for the lost, keep your mind on things above.
Keep your mind.
Then keep your mind on my Jesus love.
Think about
everything he's done for you.
Keep your mind.
He brought you out of darkness.
Thank you.
the message of the ministry? What is it you're trying to tell people?
I want people to know that in spite of everything that's happening in this world, the problem, the sadness, the sickness, God loves them. And he is that same God that they've read about in the Bible. And people say, wow, wasn't it great when he did this for Israel or for this person? And I want the people to know God is that same God.
Many feel that the Christian life is a dead life, is a boring life, is a life of rules and regulations. You can't do this, you can't do that. We want people to know that the Christian life is a life of joy. The Christian life is not that life of telling you what you can't do, but it's a life of freedom. It's a way of being taken out of the problems and the bondage that's holding you down. Even as a young person, you don't have to wait until you're middle age, until you're in your 30s, 40s, or 50s, or whatever. But as a young person, you can serve God and enjoy serving God. There's joy in this life.
It got me.
He's alive. He always helps his people in the time of need. He's always there when you're standing before the Red Sea. And that reminds me of this song. Back in the days of Israel, when they were down there in Egypt land, under heavy bondage, Pharaoh's hand. And they begin to cry out to God, God, send somebody. Oh, you know people are still crying out because they need some help. Somebody needs to cry out tonight, God, send somebody. God began to hear that cry. 430 years they were down in bondage. But one day God heard the cry, spoke to a man named Moses. Said, Moses, Moses, I heard my people cry. Egypt land. God want to set somebody free. I wonder will you let God set you free. I wonder will you let God. Let me sing this. No longer shall they for Egypt talk.
Here to let God use us to minister to the people. And I love that one verse that I always remember that Christ spoke to his disciples. He said, I am not come to be ministered to, but to minister. And that's our whole theme.
Right now, you know what's happening? You know God is moving.
it. You know God is moving.
Right now.
Moving.
Right now.
Somebody said it's moving.
Right now.
Yeah. Yeah. It's moving. Said it's moving. I said, can you feel it moving? I said, the Holy Ghost moving. I said, the Holy Ghost moving. Trying to let y'all go home now.
Hallelujah.
God's gonna do it, yeah. God's gonna do it. I want to tell you something. God have already done it for somebody here tonight. God have already touched somebody. God says, I've already done it. Don't tell him I'm gonna do it. He said, I've already done it. God says, I've already done it. I did it right here tonight. Oh, Lord.
Whoa.
I'm trying to quit, y'all.
Go ahead.
I'm trying to leave it alone. But the devil is a liar.
Yes, he is.
He said, you can't do it. I said, yes, I can.
Yes.
Because God is. God is. God bless you. Let me tell you. We love you. We have to leave you now. We have to leave. We love you.
We love you.
We have to leave you.
Say goodbye.
Yeah, 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 yeah. I want you to pray for us. We got to leave.
Goodbye.
If I never see you no more, then yeah. May the Lord be with you.
Goodbye.
May he hold your hand.
Goodbye.
You want to lead you to the promised land. May the Lord go with you. May he keep you. May he walk with you. May his face shine on you. And may the Holy Ghost ever be your joy. And everybody say, ah. Y'all can go home if you want to.